In this video, I am going to explain you about some important questions regarding the topic counter circuit. Now we will see one question here. The initial state of Mod 16 counter is 0110. After applying 35 clock pulses, the state of the counter will be. Here, for example, if we consider a Mod 16 ripple counter, it is going to consist of the number of binary bits are n equal to 4. And the maximum number of states we may find by 2 power n, which is equal to 16. And the number of counting sequences we may find from 4 zeros to 4 ones. But in this question, before giving the clock pulse, the initial state here it is 0110. By applying the first clock pulse, the next sequence we may get 0111. Like this, when we are applying all the clock pulses here, after applying 15th clock pulse, the counting sequence we may get 0101. And after applying 16th clock pulse, the same initial state we may get, that is 0110, which is equal to the initial state before applying the clock pulse. Now, for every 16 clock pulses, these are the output sequences are going to be repeating. So, multiple of 16, for the 32 clock pulse, the output, nothing but the initial sequence 0110, the same counting sequence we may get. For 33 clock pulse, the next sequence it is going to be 0111, this second sequence. And after applying 34th clock pulse, the next counting sequence is going to be 1000. And after applying the 35th clock pulse, which is the required clock pulse they asked in the question, 35th clock pulse output is going to be 1001. Now for this question, the counting sequence we may get 1001. In this manner, we may find out the any counting sequence after applying the clock pulses. With this explanation, for the same question, what is the counting sequence we may get after applying 48th clock pulse? We may get. Now, send me this answer through comment box. Now, we will see another question. Here, a 4-bit modulo 16 ripple counter uses JK type of flip-flops. If the propagation delay of each flip-flop is 50 nanoseconds. Now, find out the maximum clock frequency that can be used is equal to. Now, before going to this question, we will learn the definition of the propagation delay time. Now, coming to this definition, the propagation delay is the average transition delay time for the signal to propagate from input to outputs. Now here the signals through a gate take a certain amount of time to propagate from the inputs to the output. So this interval time indicating the propagation delay time. When we are applying inputs to the gate, it is going to take certain amount of time in nanoseconds to give the result in outputs. Now, here in the question, it mentioned here a 4-bit Mod 16 counter uses JK flip-flops. Here they mentioned 4-bit Mod 16 counter means we have to use 4 JK flip-flops because the number of binary bits will be equal to 4 number of flip-flops. And the propagation delay time for this circuit, we may find out, it can be 4 JK flip-flops means we have to multiply propagation delay time of each flip-flop multiplied by 4. Now this will be equal to 200 nanoseconds. We already know the frequency and time are universally proportional to each other. So by this, the maximum clock frequency can be find out, which is equal to 1 by total propagation delay time. So 1 by 200 nanoseconds will be equal to 5 megahertz. In this manner, we may calculate the propagation delay time for any question. Now we will see one more question, that is, here given that the frequency of the clock signal applied to the rising edge triggered D flip-flop shown in below figure is 10 kHz and find out the frequency of the signal available at Q is. Here this is a D flip-flop, but the input to this D flip-flop is going to be given from Q complement of this same flip-flop. And here the clock pulses are applied and these clock pulses are positive triggered type of clock pulse. Now we will see what happened in this T flip-flop. Here before clock pulse, the Q of T is equal to 0 here. So the Q complement before clock pulse, it is going to be 0 complement of this bit is equal to 1 here. So this 1 is applied as input to this D flip-flop. Now here D input bit can be 1. For the D flip-flop explanation, I already made one video. You go through that D flip-flop video. I am going to provide in the description box. Now coming to this, if the D flip-flop is having 1 as input, that 1 is directly we are going to get at the output side, that is Q of T plus 1. We are going to get after the clock pulse. So this D equal to 1 and after the clock pulse, the Q of T plus 1 is also 1 here. And the Q of T, now here the Q of T is going to be 1 here and this Q of T complement is going to be 0 now. Now if we transmit this 0 to this D flip-flop as input, the output Q of T plus 1 after giving the clock pulse, we may get as if D equal to 0, the Q of T plus 1 is also 0. Now by this truth table, the characteristic equation for this flip-flop, we may get as Q of T plus 1 is equal to Q of T complement. By seeing this, we can say that Q of T plus 1 is equal to 1. We may get this from Q of T. That is, so 1 complement 0. 0 complement 1. This type of flip-flop, we may call this as switch tail ring counter. And this circuit result as T flip-flop. Now coming to this question, they asked here to find out the frequency of the signal. So to find out the frequency of this signal, here it is going to be find out by the input frequency first. Here they mentioned the frequency of the clock signal we are applying at the clock pulse. It is going to be 10 kHz. So we are going to consider this clock frequency, which is divided by the number of stable states in this circuit, which is going to be, the clock frequency is here, 10 kilohertz, and the number of stable states are here, one stable state and the second stable state. So this is going to be 2, and the frequency we may calculate, which is equal to 5 kilohertz. So this is the frequency available at Q. If you have any doubts or queries regarding this topic, you may ask through comment box and give your support by subscribing my channel for more videos.